research mining. Semantic Web, let me have a little brief introduction. Let me give it like what Semantic Web is about it, and Web research mining, then why I have like motivated me to write this paper. Okay. If you look at the web like here, the most of the web pages are like, they are not, I mean to say that like, you have semi-structured kind of web pages. Most of the web pages are like semi-structured web pages. You try to see that like here, when you come to Semantic Web, we associate meaning to this web data. We associate the meaning to the web data, right? Now, the let me tell you this like shortcoming, like if you don't use the Semantic Web, what is that like here? You have a technologies like here, especially when you're going for what you call as the exchange of the data, sharing of the data between the heterogeneous systems. We try to see that like there are technologies are there, like standards are being have come. For example, like XML is there, wherein we can able to promote what you call, which promotes what you call as syntactic interoperability. I mean to say like here, two heterogeneous systems can able to exchange the data if they have an understanding, if they share a particular kind of a schema, right? But if you look at what you call as a software agent, want to share an information from an application, right? The application need to get the data, like when you want to get the share the data or like get the data from a particular heterogeneous sources, the application need to be aware about what you call as the data, right? At the same time, the heterogeneous system also need to be aware about a particular, the meaning of the data, right? Without human intervention, you see that the data cannot be shared between these applications, heterogeneous applications or two heterogeneous multiple systems. So there like here, there comes like what you call as this Semantic Web. Now actually this particular Semantic Web was envisioned by Sir Tim Berners-Lee. I think all are aware about this Sir Tim Berners-Lee, the inventor of World Wide Web. So this person who has envisioned about this one, he was thinking like it's an extension to the World Wide Web, where you try to see that the information will be given a well-defined kind of meaning. Thereby, the software is able to share what you call as the information between among them, like without human interventions. So that was the idea behind what you call as the Semantic Web, right here. Now, usually in the Semantic Web, you try to see that the mesh and the data would be represented in a machine understandable format, a machine interpretable format, like here, where this you can see the software agents can be able to share the data easily, like once they understand what it is, once they are able to get the data. Now when it comes to what you call as web usage mining, it's a like this particular area, this particular sub area, it's a sub area for this data. Where you try to say that you apply what you call as the data mining techniques to web usage data and extract the usage patterns. Generally, we try to say that the web users, they have their own kind of intentions. When they navigate the web pages, they have their own kind of intentions, they have their own interest, awareness. So once if you are able to, what you call as like here, the interest is, you can say that the interest is being accumulated in what you call as this web research data. Usually like whenever web users interact with what you call as web applications, the request, the information about the request is recorded in what you call as log files. Now these log files are very rich source of what you call as extracting the navigation patterns. So now this, you have a web usage mining and semantics. Now how these two particular kind of fields, where there is a question of what you call as synergy between the Semantic Web and the web usage mining. We can able to associate what you call as semantics with this web usage data to try to extract what you call as more interesting kind of a usage patterns. So there is what like what there is what point like where like the Semantic Web synergizes with what you call as web usage mining. Now, what has motivated for me to go for what you call as this web mining based framework for ontology learning? I say that.
Please move to the next slide.
Yes, yes, sir. Let me tell you here, sir. Like one of the main kind of a significant kind of a component for this Semantic Web, to realize the Semantic Web, to implement the Semantic Web, one of the important kind of a standard is ontology. It is the ontology which will be playing a very important kind of a role to try to promote what you call as a syntactic interoperability to a semantic interoperability. But the problem is that the acquisition of the ontology is a challenging kind of a task. To gather this ontology, it's, I mean to say this, to get what you call as
the ontology,
that's one of the very most challenging kind of a task. So that made me to go for what you call as this webmind based framework for ontology learning. So this is the outline of my presentation here. Brief introduction about semantic web and ontology learning here. I've already given for you this semantic web, what semantic web is trying to do. Then like what is the issues and challenges which are facing in this what you call as ontology learning approaches. And then like what made motivated for me to go for this semi-automatic ontology learning approach. Then the proposed work, what we have done. And then the architecture, like here, I'll try to explain about this. And the experiments and results will be discussed. And then we have what you call as the future work. As I said for you people, like here, this ontology plays a very important kind of role. Like, what is this ontology about? This standard is about it. This is in simple terms, I can say that it is a formal structure which realizes what you call as semantic web. It is a set of vocabulary of terms and the relations between those kind of terms. Formally also, we can define it here, yes, in terms of a five-tuple. Okay. Now, it is this particular kind of some ontology, like once you have an ontology, we can able to realize, implement what you call as this semantic web. You have ontology learning, like what is this ontology learning is about it? It's a process of extracting or constructing the ontology from different kind of sources using data mining techniques. Or various knowledge mining techniques you can say this here, right? So you have various kind of approaches are there for ontology learning. You have a semi-automatic approach, you have what you call as automatic approach, and manual construction of ontology is possible, right? So among all these kind of approaches, like if you save it here, usually like when you are preferring what you call as a manual ontology construction, there are problems are like being faced with like here. So one has to be, need to have a complete partition of what you call as the knowledge engineer or the domain experts in trying to construct the ontology. The other things are like here, you see that most of the ontology which is being constructed manually, like here, it's being faced by these problems, like it is error prone, time consuming, like here, because basically the person who are like trying to construct the ontology should have a complete knowledge of the domain. And then it is a costly effort, like here, and mostly it is biased to what you call as the person who versus motivations, or the person for the specific work of purpose that motivated their construction. You have approaches like here, there are a lot of research efforts are being done in what you call as like constructing the ontology learning in what in a manual way, like here. An example like what you call as Wikipedia. Wikipedia is like here completely a structured kind of a thing. Today we try to see even a parallel to this, Wikipedia, we have DBpedia, which is a semantic web pages, semantic way of using what you call as Wikipedia, right? So like here, if you're looking like going for this semantic approach, like the approach is also like way needed here, depending on the kind of the data that is being used. Ontology approaches are like being implemented on structured pages, web pages, unstructured pages, and semi-structured web pages. Like since most of the web content is in semi-structured pages, like this has motivated us to go for what the semi-automatic construction of ontology using what you called as data mining techniques. So I use what you called as like web content mining and web usage mining, both the combination of web usage mining and content mining in constructing this ontology. Basically, this is the architecture of my system here. There are two major kind of components. I extracted what you called as the concepts from web content mining. At the same time, I have extracted what you call as conceptual relationship from using web usage mining here. There are two components, main kind of components are there, like here. So this is something, this component relates to web content mining, and this one relates to what web usage mining here. The input for this web content mining, now web content mining is very much similar to what you call as the text mining. It is I extract what you call as useful information or extract concepts from web pages, right? So morning, early in the morning, like one of my friend has discussed about topic modeling. He was clustering the web pages, like the deep web pages, to try to extract what you call as the surface pages. The similar fashion like here, we are trying to use the data mining techniques to extract the contents from these web pages. And later, like here, we are trying to use what you call as, we are applying the web usage data. In the sense, like whenever users uses the web application, his requests are being recorded in the weblog files. So using the usage data, how we are trying to extract what you call as conceptual relations, and the conceptual relations which are extracted from web pages are being refined at using this one. These are being like given to this knowledge engineer who will be trying to suggest what kind of conceptual relations need to be added or update the ontology data. Right? these are the four phases, like here, this like our architecture, our frameworks involves architecture. The first one is like how do you extract web page content, extract concepts and conceptual relations from web content mining. So basically, like here, if you look at here, our framework is not completely taking all the web pages of what you call as the all the web pages into consideration as a part of what you call as the concept conception process. Now, it is taking.
Please hold the mic.
Yeah. Yes.
Talk is recorded in video.
Yes, sir. Usually, the approach is an iterative approach here. Basically, I am trying to extract the significant concepts from the web pages. So if you look at the web pages, like here, most of the web pages may not be like what you called as follow the syntax of HTML. So I used, I pre-processed the HTML pages before applying this process. Later I used what you called as a Java-based SAX parser to try to extract this concepts. I will try to extract these concepts, words and construct a formal structure. To get the the exact kind of a concepts, like even I attached what you call as the parts of speech tags. I have associated with what you call as the words which I have extracted during the parsing. That's a popular as well as a common renewal kind of algorithm in extracting the frequent item sets. It uses the prior knowledge of the candidate items in generating the frequent item sets. The same kind of a concept I have used in what you call as generating this, extracting these concepts. So I have calculated, I have taken two things into consideration while I am calculating or extracting the significant concepts. One is like here, the frequency with which the concept is being involved in the web pages. The other thing is like here, what the frequency of the HTML markers, HTML tags which is containing the particular kind of a concept. So these are the two things I have taken into consideration while I am calculating the weighted frequency of the concepts. The concepts that have a weighted frequency higher than the externally specified threshold value are considered to be most significant concepts of the web pages. So I used what you call as a threshold value here, okay, not to filter what you call as the concepts. Not all the concepts are like likely to be significant. So I use some kind of a concepts, I use a threshold value to control them. as I said for you, like here, I use what you call as this approach algorithm in generating the standard word sequence generation. From the standard word sequence generation, I extracted the most significant kind of a concepts. Sequence is identified as not significant. Then those kind of a sequence of words cannot be used in determining what you call as the significant concepts of the web pages. So those word sequences are being eliminated from what you call as standard list of word sequences. I extended this approach algorithm to my concept extraction process, where you can try to see like here how I am able to find what you call as generate this frequent concept sets. So this both the algorithm, I extended this one algorithm here for the same one concept. Once I extracted what you call as this significant concept sets, then I try to extract the conceptual relationship that exists in between these concepts. So as in the morning, like my friend was trying to say, like here, so how I was relating to the concept. So suppose example, if I got a set of significant concepts, Now, how am I able to relate to these concepts? I was looking at what you called as the frequency at which these two particular kind of concepts are occurring in it here. Right? So, morning, like even sir, like Raghunathan sir, like Natarajan sir was asking, like here, how are you trying to consider those concepts? How you are saying that those are frequent, like here, how are you trying to find what you call as the relationship between these concepts? The frequency, like here, at which these two concepts are occurring frequently in the web pages. So that is what we have taken that concept, and then we have extracted what you call as this conceptual relationships. So, like only this web content mining, we are not like gone with only web content mining, even we have used what you call as web usage mining. Look at ma'am, like here, what I have done is like here, I have taken a log file, this is my log machine. Usually this is like the usage data. So what I have done is I have reprocessed the web usage data because the raw log file may be containing a lot of information. The irrelevant records which are there, like here, the request for the images, the non-responded web request, the request for what you call as like being requested by software crawlers, software agents are being removed. So after that, like here, we have identified the user sessions. The user sessions are being clustered here. They are being, we have identified what you call as the user sessions here. So like while identifying the user sessions, we have taken what you call as a 30 minute of a timeout, default timeout, in trying to break the users cluster streams. So that is what the difficult, the heuristic kind of measure we have taken, 30 minutes. Okay. So once the user sessions are being identified here, they are being mapped to what you call as multi-dimensional vector space model of URL references. You can just look at here, like I have the user sessions here. This is the like example I have taken for 5 pages. So this is like user sessions. So there what I have done, I have mapped into a multi-dimensional vector space. You can try to see here, the web pages which are visited here, I marked as a 1. The unvisited web pages are being marked as a 0. Right? So once I constructed a multidimensional vector space model, I have applied what you call as a clustering algorithm in order to extract these clusters. These clusters are being representing those kind of web transactions which are like similar in the co-occurrence of the URL references. So after constructing these clusters, these are the different types of clusters based on different properties I have done it here. Once I have constructed the clusters here, then I have tried to apply what you call as sequential pattern mining on those clusters, not to generate the frequent pattern sets or concept sets here. So after that, like here, I have generated what you call as the association rule from this page sets. Now association rules will be trying to tell what kind of association you exist, what kind of a relationship that exists between these concepts. Those are, after identifying the conceptual relationship, these are being like forwarded to the website, the knowledge engineer or a domain expert who will try to decide like here what kind of concepts need to be added to the early existing kind of website ontology, or like we can able to delete those kind of concepts or relationships that exist in the ontology which are not relevant. So that is what being decided like here. So these two things reports from the conceptual relationships extracted from the web content mining and the web usage mining are being forwarded to the ontology engineer. So therefore, like here, we try to modify it, or like here, we can try to start with what you call as scratch. So here, why I have been preferred like this semi-automatic, why I have been telling that like my ontology learning process is a semi-automatic, is that I found that like here, after getting what you call as extracting the conceptual relations, we are trying to give to what you call as the ontology engineer. So that is like here, there is a human involvement is there available there in the process. It's not completely automatic, it is semi-automatic. So for the experiments, we have taken the a website of a university, anonymous website, university website, even the log file and the domain ontology related to this university was being taken. We collected the data for nearly 1 month, like here. It was around like 25,540 page views to be collected. I mean to say page views here, like here, it means to say records. Then like here, after pre-processing the tuple sweeping, I mean to reviewing all those kind of relevant kind of records, the number of instances which are being left out like here was 6,892 records. Like later we have generated the sessions on average basis of it was like there was a mistake like 80 have written it was 25. On average basis of 25 sessions per day was being generated. So like for editing the ontology we have used what you call as a pretty tool. It's a very popular kind of a tool in editing or like constructing the ontology. To represent the ontology, the knowledge engineer has used, we use what you call as OWL language. OWL language is the like a formal language representing the ontology. To interface with this ontology, we have programming languages. If a Java based Jina framework is there, with the help of which we can able to interface with what you call as semantic web. We have used the Java programming language in implementing in extracting the concepts from the web content mining as well as web usage point of view. So usually like earlier the ontology was this one. I have taken from the university website, university ontology, where we can try to see this one like here. I'll try to tell you here. So you can able to find like here, there's a student. Let me show you the things like here. These are the association rules, like example has shown of the association rules which are being generated. You can see the student page, after accessing student page, the user has access to the professor and teaching assistants. Nearly like 2.5% transactions, they are supporting this particular kind of a rule. This hints something like saying that like the student page is associated to what you call as teaching assistant. I mean to say, the student concept is associated with what you call as teaching assistant concept. So that is like, that hint like here, that is trying to give us like, these two particular kind of a concepts are related. Right? So I have modified like, later you can see it is here. I have tried to see that like, this university research assistant and the student, let me show you, here. Student, I have related student and what you call as university research assistant. Modified ontology when compared to the data ontology you see it. You don't have, you have a student separately, you have a what you call as the research assistant separately here. You can see the research assistant separately. So it was being modified, the ontology was completely modified based on this what rules generated. Even you can see this like there is a nearly 2.2% of the transaction. I mean to say 2.2% of the transaction of the whole is supporting this particular rule. We have the support and the confidence are the two measures we have taken to try to find the most interesting kind of concepts like here. So this rule like saying that this lecturer kind of a concept and the course kind of a concept and the research assistant concept are related. So we modified based on this one like here. So likewise we modified our complete ontology like here. Okay. Later like we evaluated this ontology based on this approach. Called as human evaluation approach. There are different approaches are there like here, the one gold standard evaluation approach, application based evaluation approach, data driven evaluation approach and human evaluation approach here. We felt like here for our research like here, this particular kind of the fourth one human evaluation approach was like best suited like. Wherein like here, the ontology was being examined, assessed by the knowledge engineer who tried to find out like how well our ontology was meeting the requirements, standards and the criteria, right? A conclusion like here, what I have done it like I have applied a semi-automatic approach in ontology learning using the data mining techniques on unstructured kind of web pages. I applied both this like web content mining and web usage mining in extracting this view. My future plans are like, even I want to apply what you call as web structure mining in my approach. So even I want to apply, use what you call as the links, hyperlinks which are there in the web pages, even into that into account like here in determining the important kind of concepts. I have right now for this proposed work, I applied only one, I extracted the ontology, constructed the ontology for only for one particular website. So later I want to extend this work for the domain specific multiple websites, not for one website, multiple websites belonging to, for a particular kind of a specific domain type. So that's what, this is my future work. So the reference is like here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody have any questions? See, the question I had was that you discovered that teaching assistant is related to the professor's web page, but that information is in the link, an HTML page is a selection of links. Obviously, it would be related if it's linked. So what additional information are they getting other than the fact that because there is a link, somebody is going to click on that link in the HTML page. So by doing the web usage mining, what additional information?
Like whatever I have shown you, madam, like this one, like those.
What are the new relationships that you found in it?
Whatever the diagram which I have shown you, which was the model of this ontology model, like where you are showing the concept hierarchy. Usually in the web pages, the web application, we try to see that like most of these links may not be, I'm speaking about those kind of web pages where the links are not appropriate. So the student link, the student web page may not be having a link to directly to the speaking assistant. So in those kind of web pages, how to extract, how ontology playing the role, that I'm trying
to. Do you have such example? Mm. Do you have those kinds of examples where there's no direct link, but you found the link? There is no direct HTML link, but you found the link between two different concepts.
This is only an example sake I have taken, man. But there are other concepts are there where like, though there are two concepts may be related like here, but they may not be linked properly. So to see that even the web user's intentions are being extracted.
Did you discover that in an example is what happened?
The pages are there, but
you have not included.
No. Only we found like here. So as per, we were trying to determine using the association rules. We found that the student kind of web page was totally related to the teaching assistant kind of web page. So we found that these two are related mostly. So we found.
And why 30 minutes? 30 minutes people don't, they do very, very many different things in one session.
Do you
separate them by something? I mean, I may be booking an airline ticket, moving on to some of the research projects. I may be doing five different things, and 30 minutes is a long time to stick to one.
Mm-hmm.
One particular idea.
Basically, like, based on the literature, man, you have found that, like, many of the things, like, during this sessionization, most of the approaches are using this 30 minutes idle time. So, they have, I mean, literatures.
So, you may find very unrelated concepts when you do 30 minutes. Is that
for the idle time is something like the research. People, I mean, who are working on this one, they have found that mostly the user will be leaving. I mean, to say from one session to second session, like here, mostly he was having a 30 minutes of time. So that is like based on the literature, I have taken it. It's not my idea, like 30 minutes. Like mostly, I have seen like in most of the web research mining jobs, we found that it was a 30 minutes only, ideally.
Yeah, if you use 30 minutes, I'm just asking, you define completely unrelated concepts. People are visiting completely unrelated concepts. Because it's long, did you find that discovery of modeling?
Yeah, you mean to say like if you reduce the time or if you increase the time,
yes.
The concepts are being like here.
Yes, what is the strength of the relationship?
Earlier, not this project, I was working in other, I mean, what of the area, like my area was something like how do you apply the semantics in the web usage mining. So in the other papers, I have already worked with this one, like here. So by reducing to 20 minutes, I have found like most of the concepts were extracted more like. Well, I have done the 20 minutes only. So I haven't seen the more time. I have seen the less time, like 20 minutes I have seen. But here, as per this experiment, like here, the prototype model which I have, prototype system which I have developed, I have used only 30 minutes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Your actual time limit is 20 minutes only, but you have taken 30 minutes. I was wondering why you have taken 30 minutes. But for your research, you are considering 30 minutes sessions a lot. So, by applying the same principle, you have taken 30 minutes. But please note that foreign conferences, you know, the ones organized by IEEE, if they allot you 15 minutes, if you overshoot the time, you will be just cut off and the next speaker will be called. But ARCC is not like that. It gives you as much time as you want, as long as we can. Support all time. Try to restrict your time. Mm-hmm. Very interesting work. Mm-hmm. All the best for your future research. Thank you. University